Injecting peptides like BPC-157 over the area of pain does not result in that peptide going directly from where you injected it to directly the area of pain. And this is a big misconception and truthfully a lot of bro science. What happens when you do a subcutaneous injection is that that medication, drug, peptide, whatever it is going to get absorbed by the blood vessels that are in the subcutaneous tissue. When you inject in the subcutaneous tissue, there is a layer of fascia that lies over top of the muscle deep to the subcutaneous adipose tissue. That fascia is there to prevent things from invading deeper. It's there as a way for our body to protect ourselves from invading infections and things like that. And so if, let's say, you have a rotator cuff tear, supraspinatus tear, and you think, I have pain right over the front of my shoulder, so I'm gonna inject BPC right directly over where my pain is. And because I'm doing that, it is going to work better than me injecting subcutaneously over my abdomen. Unfortunately, that just doesn't make sense based on physiology. And if you look at all of the literature on route of administration, which we know is in animals, but the route of administration does not matter. So doing oral is actually the same as doing subcutaneous. What happens when you do that sub-Q injection is that it gets absorbed by the blood vessels in the subcutaneous tissue that then gets distributed throughout your body, and then it goes to areas that are honing in, hey, we need healing in this area, and that could be your rotator cuff in this example. But the exact same thing happens when you do that injection over your abdomen. It gets absorbed by the blood vessels, goes systemically, and then goes to that area. If you want to do the injection over your shoulder, great, go ahead, do it. I just know that there's too many people who have pain in weird areas or difficult to reach areas who have reached out being like, how do I inject it in my low back? Or, oh, do I have to inject it into my neck? You don't have to. Just do it subcutaneous in the belly. It's going to work just the same. There's no difference between injecting in the abdomen versus over the area of pain when we are talking about how that peptide gets to the damaged tissue.